Hey, welcome to another edition of Microsoft Entra Extended E-Learning Series. Signing with social accounts is an essential capability for organizations as it streamlines the authentication process and enhances user experience. It simplifies the signing flow as users can utilize their existing social accounts to sign in, increasing conversion rates and user satisfaction. My name is Joel Orbit and I am Product Manager with the Microsoft Identity Product Group. And in this video, I will discuss how to integrate social identity providers into your application's sign-up and sign-in flows. I will cover methods to enhance and personalize the registration journey, ensure strong security, and maintain effective user administration by using Microsoft Entra Extended for external applications.
Microsoft Entra External ID allows users to access your application using social or enterprise accounts from various identity providers, like Facebook and Google. This means that users can conveniently use their existing accounts to sign in, eliminating the need to create a separate credentials specially for your application. The sign-in process starts when application prompts for authentication. Users are redirected to Microsoft Entra External ID sign-in page, where they have the option to sign in using their username and password or choosing one of the identity providers you configured. By selecting an identity provider, users proceed to authenticate with that identity provider. On the first time users authenticate with the identity provider, they may be asked by the identity provider to consent to share certain information with Microsoft Entra External ID, such as their display name and profile picture. Upon successful authentication, users are redirected back to Microsoft Entra External ID to complete their registration, at which point the user will be asked to provide additional information tailored to your application needs. Then Microsoft Entra External ID creates the account in the directory using the unique identifier of the social account and the information entered by the user. Then the user gains access to your application. Social account credentials are managed only by their identity provider. Microsoft Entra External ID associates the social account by using the account unique identifier shared by the identity provider. The account that is created and managed by Microsoft Entra External ID allows you to store additional information about the user, enable multi-factor authentication, govern their access to your application, and more. Let's dive into the sign-in process. I will be demonstrating the sign-in flow using the Wood of Groceries demo application, or woodofdemo.com. It's a worldwide retail food chain that is integrated with Microsoft Entra External ID for their online grocery shopping platform. From the right side of the screen, click on Select a Use Case button. From the list of use cases, select the Sign Up and Sign In with a Social Account option. Read the instructions. You can also learn how we configure the Woodroof tenant. To start the demo, select the Start the Use Case button. On the sign-in page, select the desired sign-in option. In this example, choose the Facebook button. You may need to sign in to your Facebook account. I have already signed in to Facebook, so I skip the Facebook sign-in step. On the first time you sign in with your Facebook account, consent to the required permissions. It allows Facebook to share a subset of your Facebook profile information, like your display name and profile picture. To consent and proceed, select Continue. After you signed in and consent to the required permissions, you will be asked to create a Wood of Groceries account in Microsoft Entra External ID and supply additional information. But before you start filling out the form, notice that the sign-up form can be fully customized, including the user attribute to collect, such as the display name, country, and city. You can also use custom user attributes. Custom user attributes allow to extend the user profile schema, collect and store additional information about the user, like the special diet, a promo code, and Woodroof policies. The sign-up form accommodates a variety of user interface input elements, including text fields, checkboxes, and radio buttons. And you can also add your own business logic using custom authentication extension to events. The first event is the on attribute collection start, which occurs just before this page is loaded. It allows you to pre-fill values like the country, Spain, and the promo code that was auto-generated. You can also run some validations, like the social account is registered in your system. The second event is on attribute collection submit, which I will demonstrate in a moment. Enter your display name, leave the country, and enter an incorrect city, Berlin. Accept the Woodroof terms, use, and privacy policies. Finally, select the next button to create the Woodroof account. and an error message appears saying that the Woodgrove does not operate in this city. This input validation is done by using the custom authentication extension on attribute collection submit event Woodgrove configured. You can also block the signup process or modify the data entered by the user. Change the city to Madrid and complete the registration. Great, a signup is successfully completed and the display name appears in the header. And now you have the option to add items to the shopping cart. Select your name from the header. It shows a security token that was returned to the Woodgrove application from Microsoft Entra External ID. It indicates that you signed in with a Facebook account. Next, let's learn how to configure your tenant. The sign in with social account option involves creating an application within the identity provider service. This step establishes a trust relationship between the identity provider and your Microsoft Entra External ID tenant. During the application registration process within the identity provider, it is necessary to supply certain details such as application name, icon, and links to your organization privacy statements and term of services and more. The most crucial detail, however, are the redirect URLs, which specifies the list of valid or trusted URLs the identity provider allows to redirect the user after they complete the sign-in. These URLs are the Microsoft Entra External ID endpoints, allowing the identity provider to return the user back to your application. Subsequently, the identity provider will supply you with a client ID and client secret. Then in Microsoft Entra External ID tenant, you register the identity provider with its application ID and application secret, and finally enable it in a user flow. Now let me show you how easy to register the Facebook identity provider in your tenant. Go to Microsoft Entra Admin Center at entra.microsoft.com and sign in with your administrator account. From the menu, select External Identities. Select All Identity Providers. Then select the Configure link next to Facebook. For the Client ID, enter the application ID of the Facebook application you created. For the Client Secret, enter the application secret of the Facebook application you created. Select Save. At this time, the Facebook identity provider has been set up in your tenant, but it's not yet available in any of the sign-in pages. You need to add the Facebook sign-in option to a user flow. From the menu, select User Flows. Then select the user flow you want to add the Facebook sign-in option to. Under the identity providers, select Facebook. Then select Save to save the changes. That's it. Your user flow is ready to use. No need to make any changes to your application. As we conclude, it's important to note another key advantage of using Microsoft Entra External ID. It simplifies your application setup by managing the federations with various identity providers for you. This means no need to handle multiple identity providers and different security tokens in your application. Furthermore, Microsoft Entra External ID accommodates a variety of types of applications and authentication protocols. For example, a mobile application that operates on OS2 or OpenID Connect protocols can effortlessly enable sign-in with a SAML identity provider. And vice versa, a SAML application can allow its user to sign in with OS2 and OpenID Connect identity providers.
This tutorial covers the federation of Microsoft Entra External ID with social identity providers, including a walkthrough of Facebook sign-in flow. The principle applies to other types of identity providers like Google. We also detail the type of user's data retained in Microsoft Entra External ID, which facilitates storing of additional user information and governs their access to your application. You are encouraged to further explore its functionality and learn how to register social identity providers and integrate them into a user journey. Also, for better security posture, implement multi-factor authentication. For more in-depth information, please refer to the article linked in the video description. Thanks for watching this video and see you soon. Goodbye.